I'm Dr. Charles Boulay, and with respect to homework in my VT practice, it's a crucial component of what we do. I work with primarily a rural community, people coming in from very far distances across Alberta and Western Canada, and as such, I've had to adapt to their needs. You know, the choice is either we work with these people or we don't. And so in many cases, what I have is parents acting as proxy therapists. I train the parents, I provide them with resources online, and then they go back and work with their children at home, and then they come back for follow-ups, or we follow up as well using electronic media. And so the homework component in my practice is absolutely a cornerstone element, and much of the material that I have developed is centered around that to facilitate that process. Certainly with the patients who come and work with me in clinic, homework is still absolutely crucial. I don't believe that we're going to be making any significant headway without having the patient work at least to some extent at home to reinforce what they're learning at the clinic.
My name's Richard C. Lawden. I've been practicing in Massachusetts for 38 years. I'm on faculty. I was in private practice for 25 years part-time. And I actually don't think of vision therapy as homework versus not homework. We use an in-office home-based program. And the way that we do our therapy is that when patients come into the clinic, we teach them specific exercises. And then they go home and they work on them. We have an unwritten contract that basically they do a minimum of 20 to 30 minutes a day, 5 days a week. We call Saturday and Sunday key days. So that's therapy to me. That's not homework. Why is it important? Because basically the visual system exists in everybody 7 days a week. So what we're looking to do is change behavior. And in order to change behavior, you need to have repetition. And that repetition is really key for me in being successful. The other issue is I work with students, and every 3 months I have a new group of students, and so when they come in, they have limited knowledge, and hopefully when they leave, they have more extensive knowledge, but they're only with me for 3 months. And so they basically need to learn a few techniques, and those techniques need to be repeated, and they need to master them. I recently came across a quote by an individual, George Leonard. I'm not really sure who he is, but I like the quote because it talks about mastery. And he talks about mastery from the fact that we fail to realize that mastery is not about perfection. It's a process, a journey. The master stays on the path day after day, year after year, and the master is willing to try and fail and try again for any length, for as long as he or she lives. The point is that you have to change a visual behavior from a standpoint of the patient being aware there's a problem, and then it has to become automated to the point that the system works on its own. And the only way you're going to do that is through repetition. And so in my experience, vision training is not what I would call the most exciting experience on a day-to-day level, but as they learn the skill and as they ingrain the skill and as they function with that skill, that ultimately makes a difference in how they perform. So that's why I don't like the word homework. I don't see it as homework. I see it as part of a vision therapy program. I know people do vision therapy differently. For me, it basically is important that it's a part of my program. I was told by somebody many years ago that you can't do home vision therapy. And I was relatively young at that point, and I was a little offended, but I've come to understand very clearly what the individual was telling me. And what he was telling me is that he couldn't do home therapy. I can do home therapy. I've been doing it for 38 years, and it's successful. I wouldn't know how to do vision training without that component.
I'll just introduce myself, Yves Bastien from Montreal. For specific cultural reasons, we can say that up here in Montreal, many optometrists tried the basic normal model of in-office training, and we all move towards out-of-office training, mainly homeworks, which means home training, which works very well for us. And one of our study group members is Margaret Ronis, at one time worked in Bob Kraskin's office, and tried to apply the same model up here. In this cultural setting, it didn't work well, and now she's doing mostly out-of-office training, home therapy, which means a lot of homework. And just as myself and the other behavioral optometrist up here, office visits are usually designed to monitor very closely what the patient, child or adult, has been doing at home, really doing that well, and then teaching new exercises and using some in-office stimulation, but basically visits are once every second or third or even sometimes every fourth week. It's a very cost-effective model because I can manage about 150 vision therapy patients all at once, and I have only two therapists. So it can be quite cost-effective. And my overall, I'd say people who join the program and drop out before, you know, most, we all get patients who come in for a couple of visits and then drop out. So we have a about 70% of people who start the program who complete it, which is not that bad. Compares, I suppose it compares pretty well with other things, other people's statistics. And most people who drop out of the 12 to 16 visit program, they drop out after one or two visits, and the rest usually fall until, if they stop early, it's because they've had early results.